Hello, and welcome. Today, I bring some bad news. The Sudachi emulator received a DMCA notice from Nintendo. Let's discuss the future of Nintendo Switch emulation. But moving away from the bad news, let's talk about new projects that might come to Android, like Ryujinx and a version of Cemu expected in 2025. Uzuy Even goes further and introduces two new configurations to improve performance on low-end devices. Starting with Ryujinx, in recent updates, it has been greatly optimized for Adreno processors. Although the focus is on new PCs with ARM architecture, having a functional emulator on ARM makes the process of porting it to Android easier. Many still defend Ryujinx for its accuracy, and it really is impressive. Will we ever see Ryujinx on the Android operating system? I feel we are getting closer, especially considering that our other hope, Strato, seems to be at a standstill. It might be that they are waiting for the dust to settle from Nintendo's lawsuits and DMCA notices before releasing their project. Another project that seems to be finally being ported to Android is Cemu. Unlike other projects like Uzuy, the development of Cemu for Android is not being carried out by the original developers of the project. However, one of the developers behind NetherSX2, the best PlayStation 2 emulator for Android, is leading this project. Currently, there is already a preview version of the emulator, but the developer stated that it is not available to the public, and there's no point in asking, as he will not provide the file at this moment. He promised to post a video of the project working soon. Although the WiiU has a limited library and few major games, bringing Cemu to Android would be a great help. This would allow us to play games like Mario Kart 8, and even Zelda Breath of the Wild with much lower requirements than what we have today in Nintendo Switch emulators. Cemu on Android is a frequent question on the channel, and in my opinion, the project should have been a reality for some time now. Hey everyone, I'm back because, in the middle of the night, someone managed to compile and distribute a version of Cemu, and I tested a few games. I went straight for the 3D games. I'll post another video detailing my experience with some specific games, but I'll give you a heads up. Although the project is in a very experimental stage, it already renders things quite well. I managed to run Super Mario 3D World between 20 and 30 FPS, Zelda Breath of the Wild was only at 7 FPS, but I was able to run it, and Mario Kart 8 also ran between 20 and 30 FPS. But in my opinion, it still felt slow. I'll leave the download link for the project in the video description, but be warned, if you want to test it, don't set your expectations too high. Perhaps when the project matures or when they implement support for turnip drivers for Snapdragon GPUs, the project will become very promising. But in the current stage, where all recompilers are in JIT mode and are ported from Windows, there will still be performance issues. And Uzuy doesn't stop with its updates. In its latest version, it brought two more improvements focused on low-end devices. Now, there's no longer a need for separate versions for 4 GB RAM and 6 GB or more. The app itself detects and optimizes performance according to the available RAM. Additionally, issues with mods, updates, DLCs, and cheats have been fixed. In the latest update, a resolution scaling issue was resolved. Two exclusive new features that we haven't seen in any Uzuy port versions so far have been added: a graphical option that reduces precision, allowing for an FPS boost, and a setting to improve CPU precision on low-end devices. The layout was also updated, removing the SNES-style buttons and introducing a cyberpunk-themed interface. Although I still can't fully recommend this project, there have been no reports of viruses or other issues so far. I'll leave the link to the project's Discord in the video description, but remember, use it at your own risk. Before we move on to our main topic, I'd like to ask you to leave a like on this video to help the channel grow even more. If this is your first time here, consider subscribing to the channel for weekly updates. And it's been about 3 days since Sudachi received a takedown request from their GitHub account due to a DMCA notice from Nintendo. I didn't report this earlier because the releases hadn't been removed yet, and it seemed like everything would be resolved soon. However, on July 10th, which is the day I'm writing this script, the entire Sudachi releases page was removed, making it impossible to obtain and compile new versions. Currently, all development is being migrated to libhack. For those who don't understand much about these processes, it's not just about moving to another site. When GitHub was taken down, a lot of existing material was lost, like all the commits and pull requests, which help developers fix bugs present in the application and implement new functions to the project. In the developer's view, this DMCA was unjustified because Sudachi no longer uses the key generator that was problematic in Uzuy, which would invalidate Nintendo's DMCA claim. However, As stated in the details, the DMCA was applied because Uzuy is primarily designed to unlawfully circumvent a technological measure that effectively controls access to a work under the Digital Millennium Copyright Act, DMCA. They also mention that this has also occurred with other repositories based on Uzuy, such as Suyu, Nuzu, Uzuy, Torzu, and Sudachi itself. Until the new repository is operational and ready to compile old builds, new users will not have easy and safe access to the project, having to resort to third-party sites to obtain the old builds. For example, on the channel's Discord, there was a user looking for a build that runs on macOS, and I couldn't help him. Now, a brief chat with you all. Why do you think Nintendo is trying so hard to shut down various projects of a console that is already in its final stages of life? Everything suggests that this is due to the launch of the new Nintendo hybrid console, which we'll call the Nintendo Switch 2. The fact that the Switch 2 has backward compatibility suggests that the consoles will likely have similar architectures. This means that having knowledgeable people who understand the system's operation, both in hardware and software, could lead to early piracy on the Nintendo Switch 2. What's happening here involves not only emulators but also MiG-Switch, which last week received several DMCA notices and even had its website taken down by Nintendo. Nintendo has a history of being weak in maintaining the security of its devices and operating systems. Piracy was already prevalent on the Nintendo Wii and Wii U, and on the Switch, there was a hack within the first few months of its release. Despite their ability to create many good games, security is not Nintendo's strong suit. For those wondering why Nintendo doesn't sue or take down Ryujinx, since the emulator is well regarded and runs many games, the answer is simple. Ryujinx's primary developer is Brazilian, and in Brazil, only the sale of pirated items is considered piracy. To explain more clearly, developing a project or reverse engineering something here is not illegal since you are not commercializing anything. Therefore, they can even have a Patreon and won't have legal problems with that unless they were selling, for example, SD cards with saved Switch games. That would be piracy because it would involve the sale of pirated items. Therefore, Nintendo can take down GitHub, Discord, and other Ryujinx-related networks, but they will never be able to prosecute those responsible, as they did with Uzuy. Even with a lot of money, Nintendo won't get very far here. And that concludes our video. Thank you for watching and see you next time.